Bonjour, c'est Monsieur Luc, c'est vendredi, on est vendredi, c'est super, vous savez ce qui se passe le vendredi, c'est vendredi de bingo, bingo de vendredi. Bon, d'accord, mais maintenant on va dire une histoire. Au fait, on va continuer notre histoire, le lapin et la lune. On va continuer parce qu'on a déjà lu la première moitié, donc il reste la deuxième moitié pour finir. Alors, avant de commencer, on va chanter bonjour, bien sûr, et préparez-vous pour le bingo à 2h30 plus tard aujourd'hui. C'est ça, c'est ce qu'on va jouer. Hi everyone, bonjour. It's Monsieur Luke with Language Sprout. Just a reminder, today is Friday, vendredi, in case you forgot. And on vendredi, on a bingo de vendredi. Bingo de vendredi. So if you aren't getting our newsletter, sign up at languagesprout.com and you'll get your bingo card. I can't really show you that in a way that works on the screen. There you go. Bingo cards come in the newsletter. Get your bingo cards ready. You can use them on a tablet or you can print them out if you want. Either way works so you can play along with us. That'll be for our mini lesson scheduled at 2:30 p.m. Central. So that's coming up in a few hours, but I just wanted to make sure you're ready for that because it's bingo and it's super fun, and you get a secret, a special message when you win bingo, and everyone wins, so it's even better for that reason. Bon, d'accord. So today, as I was saying in French, we're finishing the second half of the book we started yesterday, which is called Le Lapin et la Lune, The Rabbit and the Moon. Okay, so let's kind of sum up what happened really quick. Does everyone remember what happened in the first half of Le Lapin et la Lune? Okay, on a le lapin, le papa lapin et le clocher. Et quand ça sonne 6 heures, il y a des carottes qui apparaissent. Oui, bon, regardons. Papa lapin, oui. So there's the father rabbit. Et il y a le clocher. Oui, le clocher. La famille de lapins habite à côté d'un clocher au pouvoir mystérieux. So the rabbit family lives next to a tower that has, it's a clock tower with a bell in it. And it has mysterious powers, des pouvoirs mystérieux. And when the clock tower would ring at 6 in the evening, à 6 heures du soir, quand la cloche sonnait, il apparaissait des carottes. Il y avait des carottes qui sortaient de la terre. So carrots would come up from the ground magically, yeah? But then it stopped working, right? Then it stopped working. Un jour, la cloche cessa de retentir. The bell stopped ringing and there were no more carrots. Il n'y avait plus de carottes. Il n'y avait plus de carottes. Okay, so that's what, and that happened. And so the rabbit said, "Oh, what do I do?" And the rabbit got all this different advice. And he, the owl said, le hibou, l'hibou lui a dit de parler à la lune. The owl told him to speak to the moon. The moon said, "Oh, well, you have to play me a song with a magic flute." Il faut, oui, me faire un air, me jouer un air. De la flûte de Pan. Bon, d'accord. The rabbit went looking for this magic flute. It didn't know what to do about it. Yeah, bonjour, Aura. Bonjour, 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 Aura. Ça va? Ça va? Okay, and so the moon said, "You have to play me a song with the magic flute." Okay, and so we thought, okay, what do we do now, right? So the rabbit went to Monsieur Pon. Ça c'est Monsieur Pon. The rabbit went to Mr. Peacock to find out where the magic flute is. But if you remember, Monsieur Pon, il a des soucis de mémoire. He has memory problems. He has memory problems. He couldn't remember where the magic flute was. He couldn't even remember what his name was. Monsieur Pon. So when we left off, the rabbit, Papa Lapin, c'est bon. Ah, c'est bon. Aurora, c'est bon. When we left off, Monsieur Rabbit was with Monsieur Pon, and they were trying to remember his name, Monsieur Pon's real name. So if he could remember his name, maybe he'll be able to then remember where the magic flute is. Okay? Oui, c'est ça. So that's what happened in the story, right? That's what happened. Oh, we should sing bonjour really quick. Everyone ready? Bonjour, bonjour, comment ça va? Comment ça va? Ça va bien, merci. Ça va bien, merci. Et vous? Et vous? Oui, d'accord. OK. So, and that's right. Aurora is writing to us and telling us he can't remember his name. So we left and we saw the rabbit was naming off all these ideas for the peacock's name. Yeah, Henri, Maximilien, Théodore, Jacques, Gérard, Clément, Albert, Guy. A lot of different names, French names, right? I think Aurora, you said maybe his name is Peter, right? And in French, Peter would be Pierre. Pierre. So that was a good idea for the name for Monsieur Pont, but we still don't know what his name is. So this is where we left. Monsieur Pont ne reconnaissait pas son prénom dans toute cette liste et dit tristement à Papa Lapin, et là non. Oh, je suis malheureux sans mon prénom. Yeah. Il pleure, il est triste, le pont, il pleure parce qu'il ne reconnaît pas, il ne sait pas son nom. Il ne sait pas son nom. Oui, c'est ça. So, the peacock, Monsieur Pont, he's very sad, he's crying, he just can't remember his name. So, Monsieur Lapin, il va aider, il va aider, il essaie d'aider. Quand même. Oui. So he's trying to help him. Did anyone have any other ideas for what Monsieur Pont's name could be? Pierre. So that's we got that suggestion from Aurora. Bon, on va voir. If you have any suggestions, you can write them in the comments, but I think we're going to find it, figure it out soon. Ah, regardez. Soudain, Papa Lapin se rappela le chant de Monsieur Pont et lui dit: Eureka! Ça y est, j'ai trouvé. Monsieur Pont, votre prénom est Léon. Léon. Voilà, il s'appelle Léon. Il s'appelle Léon, c'est ça. Le pont s'appelle Léon. C'est ça le prénom de Monsieur Pont. D'accord. So suddenly, Father Rabbit remembered Monsieur Pont's song, le chant de Monsieur Pont, and he said, Eureka! I got it. Ça y est. Ça y est. I figured it out. J'ai trouvé. J'ai trouvé. I got it. Monsieur Pont, votre prénom est Léon. Léon. Vous voyez là, Léon. Monsieur Pont is named Léon. So it even rhymes with Monsieur Pont. Monsieur Pont s'appelle Léon. D'accord. Voilà. Il s'appelle Léon. Regardez son plumage. Il a ouvert sa queue. Oui. Miracle. Oui. Je m'appelle Léon. Léon, Léon! S'exclama le pont tout en déployant sa majestueuse queue. Sa majestueuse queue, c'est la queue, toutes les plumes vertes et bleues et jaunes du pont. Il a ouvert sa queue parce qu'il s'est souvenu de son prénom. Il s'appelle Léon. Il s'appelle Léon. Que c'est beau, la majestueuse queue du pont. Ah, so he opened up his beautiful tail feathers, right? Have you all ever seen a peacock's tail feathers when they're open? It's really amazing. So he was so happy when he found out his name. His name is Léon. He said it three times. Léon, Léon, Léon. And he opened up his tail feathers because he's super happy. Il est très content. Il est très, très, très content. Le lapin aussi, il est content. Il est content, c'est vrai. C'est vrai. Donc, il s'appelle Léon. Voilà, oui, c'est ça. Il a déployé sa queue parce il a reconnu son nom. Il s'appelle Léon. Bonjour Mahaila, bonjour Perry, bonjour, bonjour. C'est Monsieur Pont aussi, il dit bonjour, bonjour. Bon, regardez. Ah, mais c'est là où se trouve la flûte. Regardez. Oh, mais que vois-je caché derrière ma queue? Derrière sa queue, regardez, la queue et derrière la queue, vous voyez, qu'est-ce qu'il y a derrière la queue? C'est la flûte, c'est la flûte, c'est la flûte de Pont. Voilà, alors, dit le Pont, c'est ma flûte, tenez, monsieur Lapin, tenez, prenez-la et jouez une belle mélodie à la lune. Ah, d'accord. La flûte se trouve derrière la queue du pont. Donc, il a ouvert la queue et c'est comme ça qu'il a découvert, il a redécouvert, redécouvert sa flûte. Ah, so, right, he opened it up. He opened it up his tail up, right? And that's when he remembered the flute is right there behind, derrière, behind his tail feathers. That's where he kept it. Aha, d'accord. So he said, c'est ma flûte, that's my flute. Here you go, Monsieur Lapin. Tenez, prenez-la, take it, et jouez une belle mélodie à la lune, and play a beautiful melody for the moon. Okay, so we're getting closer. Yeah, that's what he needs to do, right? Monsieur Lapin, il doit jouer une belle mélodie à la lune. He has to play a nice melody for the moon to get the moon to help him to restart the clock. D'accord. Bon, d'accord. Allez, il va jouer. Il va jouer. L'aube était bientôt là. Il était presque 6 heures. Papa Lapin prit la flûte et joua à la lune l'air qu'il chantait à ses petits lapins chaque soir avant de se coucher. Au clair de la lune. Au clair de la lune. Voilà, c'est une chanson très très connue, n'est-ce pas? So, it was almost dawn. L'aube était bientôt là. Il était presque 6 heures. It was almost 6 o'clock in the morning. Papa Lapin prit la flûte et joua à la lune l'air qu'il chantait à ses petits lapins. So, Papa Lapin took the flute and he played a song that he would sing to his baby rabbits, his little rabbits. And he would sing it every night, chaque soir avant de se coucher. It's the bedtime song that he would sing to them. And it's called Au clair de la lune. Au clair de la lune. Voilà. Au clair de la lune means in the moonlight. Au clair de la lune. Ah, the lune was out when you got off the plane? Cool. Yeah. You have to play it a song. Au clair de la lune. This is a famous song in French. Au clair de la lune. Donc, il a chanté au clair de la lune et regardez, la mélodie monte à la tour. Regardez, c'est la mélodie du lapin qui joue et ça monte à la tour. C'est une mélodie magique, peut-être. C'est une mélodie. Vous voyez la lune et la tour, le clocher est là. Donc, il est en train de jouer et qu'est-ce qu'il y a écrit là? La lune scintilla encore plus fort et comme par enchantement, les notes de musique qui sortaient de la flûte formèrent bien vite un escalier qui permet à Papa Lapin de grimper en haut du clocher. Mais c'est magnifique, c'est vraiment, vraiment magnifique. Voilà, c'est un escalier magique qu'il peut monter. Il peut grimper jusqu'en haut du clocher, mais c'est vraiment, vraiment magique. C'est vraiment magique. Do you all know what's happening here? This is really cool. So he played the flute and the music created a magic staircase that wrapped up around the clock tower so he can climb up, grimper, climb up the clock tower to the top of the tower. En haut, il peut aller en haut, il peut grimper en haut. So it was that magic melody that created a staircase. Un escalier. Wow, c'est super. Voilà. Bon, regardez, qu'est-ce qu'il va faire? Regardez, il était 6 heures. Papa Lapin sonna la cloche et les carottes se mirent à nouveau à sortir de terre. Ah, voilà, la cloche. Il sonne la cloche, il fait ding-ding-dong, la cloche, il sonna la cloche, il est 6 heures, vous voyez, il est 6 heures, et donc il sonne la cloche, et les carottes apparaissent de nouveau, c'est vrai, les carottes apparaissent de nouveau, la magie est là, ça existe encore, d'accord. So he went up top and he got the bell to ring, at 6 o'clock. So I thought it was 6 o'clock at night, but it's actually 6 o'clock in the morning when the carrots arrive, right? So breakfast. Oui, le petit déjeuner. Bon, d'accord. Il sonne le clocher et les carottes. De nouveau, il y a des carottes qui sortent de la terre. Et les carottes sortent de la terre comme ça, comme par magie. Voilà. Toute la famille lapin fit un bon festin. C'est un festin parce qu'il avait faim pour manger. Et manger les carottes. Il fallait manger les carottes parce qu'ils avaient trop faim. Ils avaient trop faim. Et ils ont fait un bon festin. All of the rabbit family, they had a big feast. They were so hungry. Ils avaient faim. Oui. And so they ate all of the carrots and had a big feast together. Et depuis ce jour, chaque membre de la famille Lapin est heureux de tendre la main à ceux qui en ont besoin. Ah, d'accord. Et depuis ce jour, and since this day, chaque membre de la famille Lapin, every member of the rabbit family, est heureux de tendre la main à ceux qui en ont besoin. So they were always happy to lend a hand to people who needed it. Yeah. So we say tendre la main, like to reach your hand out. But it's not only that, right? You give them their hand, but it's a way of saying to help people, right? To help people who are in need. Just like the rabbit family, they had a moment when they didn't know how to get their carrots back and they needed help. So they asked for it and they finally got it. And so now they help other people and other rabbit families, maybe other animals, when those other animals need it. It's so nice, such a nice story. Ils ont donc tendre la main à ceux qui en ont besoin. C'est vraiment bon, c'est bon. Voilà, voilà, c'est bon, c'est vrai. Oui, Aurora, tu as raison. Oui, c'est vrai, c'est vrai, c'est vrai. D'accord, je crois que c'est la fin. Oui, c'est la fin de l'histoire. Ok, ça c'était notre histoire, le lapin et la lune. Le lapin et la lune, voilà, c'est ça. C'est super. C'était vraiment bon. What a nice end to the story, right? So the carrots came back, but also we got a really good idea, which is, you know, sometimes if you have to ask for help and someone helps you, you return the favor and you help other people when they ask you. It's a really, really good story. Aider. Aider means to help people. Tendre la main, to lend a hand. When someone needs it, quand quelqu'un a besoin de ça. Bon, d'accord, c'est notre histoire, le lapin et la lune. Ah oui, vous voyez là, papa lapin doit atteindre le sommet d'un clocher au pouvoir mystérieux. Mais comment une belle aventure d'entraide commence? Ah, so it's saying, papa lapin has to get to the top of the clock tower, the clock tower that has mysterious powers, but how can he do it? Mais comment une belle aventure d'entraide commence? And what you see is a beautiful adventure about mutual help, helping one another. A big adventure. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's a great book. Yeah, I agree. Aurora, c'est bon. Right, it was kind of sad because we didn't know in what was going to happen, and the peacock was sad about not remembering his name, but everything worked out. So really, really nice story. Bon, je suis content. Que ça vous ait plu. Merci. Bonjour Amélie. Je suis content que ça vous ait plu. C'est vraiment une bonne histoire. C'est une bonne histoire. Okay, I think that was a great story. A great story for Friday with a really good message for everyone. So it ended up happy indeed, and we can take that happy message with us for Friday. But if you're coming back later at 2:30, we're playing bingo. We're playing bingo with the words we've been learning this week. Those are words for hobbies in French. Get your bingo cards ready. You can find them on in our newsletter that you sign up for on languagespot.com. And so maybe you've already gotten it. You can print it out. You don't have to print it out. The way I like to do it is to put the bingo card on my tablet, and I can use it on my tablet to play. So it's easier like that, and just put little pieces down on the tablet so I don't have to use paper. Bon, d'accord. Revenez à 2h30 pour la mini-leçon de français, okay? Come back at 2:30 for a mini-leçon. And remember also, we're starting our May session of classes. We have different pricing available for classes in May, which is a continuation of our trial classes. So everything you did, if you did those classes in April, that continues into May. And we'd love if you could join us for more for that. Of course, I'm going to keep doing my story times and my mini lessons on Facebook as well. So on va chanter au revoir. On va chanter au revoir. Allez, au revoir, à bientôt, à la prochaine, merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup. Merci, 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 merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup. D'accord. Merci Amélie. Merci Aurora. Merci tout le monde qui est venu regarder. So if I don't know your name because I don't see you in the comments, merci, merci. Aurora, can you take a class? You'll have to ask your parents. I don't know if you that's ask them and you can find out. But you're always welcome to come and watch my story times and watch my mini lessons at 2:30. You can always do that. And that's something that is easy to do and doesn't cost anything. So please keep joining me for that. It's great to see everyone here. Les amis, all of my friends are here. Voilà, les amis, merci beaucoup. Merci, thanks for coming. Since it's Friday, I'm not doing any story times tomorrow or Sunday, it's the weekend, but we replay our videos over the weekend. We do reruns and you can always find all of our videos, story times and mini lesson videos. The ones that we've done, they are on our YouTube channel. You'll see a link to that in the comments with this video, in the description with this video. And these videos are saved on Facebook too, so you can always rewatch, right? So please enjoy those videos. And rewatch them if you want over the weekend so you keep doing some French over the weekend, and I'll be back on Monday with a new story time. Bon, d'accord. Allez, au revoir tout le monde. Merci, merci, merci. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir. Au revoir tout le monde. Au revoir.